How do we begin this long-term deflection downward? How much can efficiency take out and how much can solar power do and so forth? The main criteria for these are really, however, pretty simple. Whatever we do can't cause other problems. And so if we're trying to eliminate carbon and we say we go to nuclear power, well, nuclear has a number of things I'll talk about in just a moment, but that really is kind of problem switching because nuclear has its own suite and set of problems. And so the criteria here ought to be, first of all, that we don't simply switch problems from one to another. And secondly, the criteria here, our energy policy and climate policy really ought to solve lots of other things. How about a policy that speaks to security as well as climate stability and renewable energy and other sorts of things? And thirdly, it's got to be technically feasible. What we do has got to be, if it's feasible, maybe in 20 years or 50 years, it's simply too late to meet this criteria that we really only have 10 or 15 years, maybe max, in which to solve this issue. And then the criteria here, the metric for success, really, again, is very simple. It is the amount of carbon eliminated per dollar spent. And so it's the same criteria that any businessman would have for the expenditure of investment capital, but it's the amount, in this case, of carbon, not profitability, per dollar invested. And then it's got to be deployed quickly. We don't have time to wait for something that might be advantageous in 50 years and so forth. And then finally, we would hope that what we do in terms of energy policy and climate is repairable and redundant and locally accessible.